Okay, we have a lineup. Who among us is the imposter? We're gonna find out. It's Red Pomegranate 206. He done it. Oh, yeah. He's definitely sus.
I'd say so, too.
Interesting.
I think we have to eject him.
Ah, victory!
In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to pull the character from the popular video game Among Us.
And special for my members only, I made this 3D Among Us character, and it even has a backpack. And for info on becoming a member, click here.
So to fold these Among Us characters,
which have legs that walk,
and they can also be ejected Flickr style, begin with a square sheet of paper colored on one side and white on the other. I'm going to use a 6-inch square of Kami. So begin white side up and fold in half. Try to make really precise folds and crease sharply. Unfold, rotate, and fold in half in this direction. We're making a square base. Fold this corner to this point. Turn over and repeat. Now open the big pocket, put your finger inside, and push these two points together and flatten. And here we have the square base. Orient it so that the open side is nearest to you. And fold this front flap, both layers, to this crease. Actually, we want to go beyond that crease. So we're folding on this point, and we want this point to cross over that crease by 1 millimeter. So it's like that, and make the fold. I think I did too, okay. So it should look like that. And repeat on this side. So the two flaps should cross over each other by about 2 millimeters. And unfold the two flaps and fold the front flap to the top. And refold this flap on the existing crease and refold this flap on the existing crease. So the two flaps overlap again. Now fold, let's do this side first. Fold this flap behind, just lightly. Don't make a very strong fold. We're folding on this crease, but just lightly. So it's like that. And now reach in here and fold this flap inside. It's the interior flap gets folded inside on the existing crease, like that. And repeat on this side. So first make the fold very lightly, unfold, and now take this interior flap and fold it inside. So it's like that. Now fold this flap inside almost to that point there. But you can go a little bit less if you want to make the face shield a little bit taller. That's to taste. About like that is good. All right, now turn over and the open side is nearest to you. Fold this flap to this crease and fold exactly to the crease. And repeat. We're going to make a petal fold. Rotate and fold this flap over these edges. And ba-da! It's a Christmas tree. Now unfold these two flaps but leave this flap folded. Rotate and lift this front flap up so we have a boat. And now squash the sides of the boat. And the pedal fold is complete. Now turn over and we have the two legs. Fold the two legs up to this point. Unfold, and now fold them to this point. Unfold and fold them to this point. Unfold, and now lift this flap up, actually fold it over, and fold this flap to this point on the existing crease, like that, and close it. And repeat on this side. So lift this flap up, and fold this flap to that point. And close. And now turn over and fold this point to the middle. All layers. So it's like that. And repeat. Now fold the leg up as far as it goes, and this leg too. Rotate. And now fold this flap up. What we want is we want this crease. I'm also going to draw it on this side just so you can see it. We want this point to land on this edge. So fold it up. So that point lands on the edge, and we want this point to align with this edge. So if you were to extend this edge, it would hit this point. You might want to get a ruler, but I'm just going to eyeball it. So it's like that. And repeat on this side. Okay, that was the hardest step, I think. Now we're going to reverse fold this point. So basically just push it in a little bit like that. And repeat on this side. And now fold this edge like this. We're folding on this point, and we want the fold, this edge, to be parallel to this edge, like that. And same on this side. And now fold these edges up. We just want to fold it so that it makes an edge like that. And repeat. So we're just folding it in a little tiny bit. And this will seal the edges, so if you want it to be a flicker, an ejecting flicker, then it'll be nice and flat there. So you can flatten it. Okay, and now turn over, and hi there, and turn back over. And now fold this flap up between these two points. Okay, now if you want the backpack to go on this side, as in the right side here, then fold it between this point and this point. If you want it to go onto the left side, then you'll fold it between this point and this point. You see, that way the backpack will be on the left side, or on the dude's right side, depending on whose orientation it is. Okay, you get the point. So I'm gonna just do this side. It doesn't really matter. Okay. Fold up like that between those two points. And now unfold this flap. And now we're going to refold it. We're folding it on this point, but we're folding it so that we gotta turn it over. We're folding it so that this edge aligns with this edge. But more importantly, we want this to be parallel to that. Oh wow, we could just fold it right down so that the edge touches there. I just figured out that guideline. Okay, yeah, that's good. So we're folding it on this point, and this edge goes to there. And this lines up too. Okay, now turn over and fold on this existing crease, and we're going to squash it like this on the existing creases. Well, that fold is new, but the other existing creases. Okay, and now fold this flap. We're folding it on this edge, like that. And unfold. And unfold this flap right here. And make that existing crease. And continue it across. And close it back up. So it's like that. And I think it's best just to stick this under there so that it locks. Okay, we're almost done. Just fold this behind to taste. And round it to taste as well. That's a hard point to fold behind. Lots of layers there. I wonder if this little dude is inspired by R2-D2. Reminds me of R2-D2. Okay. All right, now to make these legs move, well, they move like that, and in fact, like this, I think it would make a good flicker if you flatten it really well. But if you want it to look like it's walking, I think that you need to fold these flaps like this, aligning it with the bottom edge like that, and let them go. So you have like right angles there. Now you can make it go back and forth like that. And there the dude is walking. And what else? I think that's it. So there you have it. Okay. And you can see how it flies. Whoosh. Ooh, that actually flew. And for this guy to make this little face, it's kind of complex, but I ended up doing some sort of squash folding. I'm gonna just take it apart and hope that you can figure out how it was done. So squash there and a couple pleats and folding up like this. Something like that. All right, hope you guys enjoyed making this little dude, and I'll see you guys later. Ejected!